Praise the Lord and good morning, brothers and sisters. Welcome back again.
Good morning, good brothers and good sisters. Welcome back. Yesterday we were discussing about the Word of God and Brother Hilary shared us some insight about it. Today we will ask him furthermore about how this Word of God is going to help us fight the enemy. So Brother Hilary, can you just elaborate on how do we fight this enemy with the Word of God?
Amen. Amen. Yes. Now if we strengthen, as we said yesterday, our spirit with the Word of God, the Word of God, which is going to strengthen our spirit, will defeat our body. There is always a fight between the body and the spirit, body and the soul. So the more you feed the Spirit of God, the more the victory will win. Now Jesus had fasted for 40 days and 40 nights. And after fighting for 40 days and 40 nights, the devil comes when he is the most weak. And he says, if you are the Son of God, make these stones into bread and eat. Matthew chapter 4 tells us that. That's when Jesus replies back and says, man shall not live on bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. Have we made the Word of God that important in our lives? That I'm ready to die if I have to die, but I'm not going to give in to any temptations of the devil. And that strength can come only when you continuously read the Word of God. Continuously read, okay? And meditate on the Word of God. So, what did Jesus do? Jesus overcame the devil, the temptations that the devil was throwing at him by quoting the scripture. Man shall not live on bread alone, was the scripture from Deuteronomy. So, he says, man shall not live on bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. Now, he is not done with it. The devil again quotes the scriptures. The devil also knows the scriptures. The devil knows the scriptures better than you and me. That's why so many people are confused and puzzled. Because the devil will come and say, you know, Jesus, it is also written that when you fall down, he will give your angels charge and they will bear you up in their hand. So, throw yourself down. You will become famous when the angels hold you in their arms. What does Jesus say? It is also written, Matthew 4:7, you shall not put the Lord your God to the test. So, Jesus counterquotes the scriptures. When he counterquotes the scriptures, he's winning the victory. Because the devil says, now, okay, you want to fight with the Word of God? Come, let's fight with the Word of God. And he throws the Word of God at him. And Jesus, knowing that Satan is, confusing us with the Word of God, he has given us the power to counterquote the scriptures. So he says, you shall not put the Lord your God to the test. What does that mean? You don't tell me to jump and see if the angels are holding me or not. I believe that the angels will hold me. I don't need to put the Lord my God to test. If I fall down, definitely by mistake, if I'm falling down, then he will hold me. But if I'm jumping purposely, that means I'm putting my God to the test. Okay? Then you see, finally again, when he is exhausted with everything, he comes with the pleas. He comes with the pleas. But in the third, in the verse 10, chapter 4, verse 10, even when devil is saying, please worship me and I'll give you all the glory and glamour and everything, he says, be gone, Satan, for it is written. Again, he's saying, it is written, you shall worship the Lord your God and him alone you will serve. So if you want to overcome your temptations, you cannot overcome the temptations, you cannot overcome the devil without the Word of God. So if you don't have the Word of God, you will definitely give in to temptations. You will definitely fall. You will definitely lose the battle. So my dear brothers and sisters, you need the Word of God day in and day out. So in Psalms 119, it tells us that I have hidden thy word in my heart that I may not sin against you. The Word of God has to remain hidden in my heart, that it will come when I need to overcome every temptation. Brothers and sisters, we love you very, very much. And we pray that you will spend your time, precious time given to you by God, reading the Word of God, meditating on the Word of God, and overcoming every temptation in your life. God bless you. Have a wonderful day, and see you back again tomorrow.
Bye. Take care. God bless you all.
Amen. Praise the Lord.